Hi, this is Joyce Logan. I'm so glad that you joined us today. We have some special surprises in store for you. We're going to go down memory lane, and I want you to guess who you're looking to, listening to, and looking at. And at the end of this edition, we're going to tell you who they were. Now, it's a blast from the past, so it may go back a ways. So let's see how many you can guess.
The first music I got excited about, I think, was probably folk music, because that's what I grew up with, listening to my dad play. But very quickly, I discovered everything from gospel, black gospel. The first album I owned was a black gospel album, Andre Crouch album. Then I discovered blues music, and I discovered rock and roll. And of course, growing up in Kentucky, you know, I couldn't help but grow up with a lot of bluegrass music around. I really allowed myself to draw on all of that for this album. I think probably more so than ever, the real rootsy music that I grew up loving. That's what this album represents more than probably any of my albums up to date. It was just a chance to kind of break all the rules and, you know, just kind of make the music that I'd always kind of wanted to make.
It's so important that I come here and refill. It's a place where I come to refocus, to refill my spirit so that I can continue to give out. It's very important to me and my family. My mom and dad both sang, you know, so church was a very important part of our family. My mom had 7 boys straight and 3 girls at the end. BB is the last fella, and I'm the first girl. So it was always a crowd in the Winans home. A childhood that I would never trade for anything. For years, the Winans family, my mom and dad, would sponsor us and little concerts in Detroit, Michigan. And my parents used to sit in the back and wonder if anybody would come see their children. I think to this day she still wonders if they're going to show up. You know. My Florida brothers got discovered by Andre Crouch, and they formed the group The Winans. BB and I went away to Charlotte, North Carolina to be a part of a ministry there and to sing really in a group with other people. And they started giving us songs to sing together. And one thing led to another, and Sparrow signed us. It's not like we set out to be accepted by mainstream. It just happened.
How many of y'all got a right to play?
Heart that can't believe that you've been given faith.